Artist Stefan Talian started painting with his fingers after being inspired by an artist who had a workspace near his at the studio door.
I didn't touch it with brush, just with my hands, and it's fun. It brings me closer to the canvas, like I'm loving it.
That's the kind of creative alchemy Patrick Stillman wanted to inspire when he opened the studio door in 2015.
When I started out with the studio door, I wanted to create a space where artists could engage with each other and learn from each other and grow quickly.
And that's what he did for 4 years in North Park. But then rising rents forced the studio door to close.
I never had a plan B, and I had built such a beautiful community that I wanted that to continue.
The studio door was what he called an arts incubator and featured not just a gallery, but studio space for emerging artists like Talian. When the studio door closed, Talian had to find another place.
I found cheaper place and bigger place. I had a lot of walls, but it was kind of like office space, so nobody saw those paintings on the walls, so I got kind of depressed.
But sometimes not having a plan can yield unexpected results.
After 4 years, I had this break. Even though I didn't want it, it gave me this opportunity to think about what was successful, what I could do differently. And this new space is really, I think, pumping up the volume in showcasing artists' voices and their visions.
The studio door found a new, bigger home in Hillcrest and reopened after a 6-month closure.
And now the studio door has turned into something that's a much larger community that is really propelling art in ways that are fitting sort of the gaps in the spectrum of San Diego's visual art scene.
What makes the studio door unique is this mix of a gallery with artist studios, allowing people to engage with the artists. This way, people can see not just finished art, but also get a window into such intangible things as creativity, imagination, and inspiration. Talian is thrilled to be back at the studio door and working amongst a community of artists.
For me, when I walk in this place, it's kind of like 18 hearts beating. Like when you go through those little studios and everyone is so different and it's so inspiring. Like I'm just feeling really at home.
Caitlin Alfaro is one of his new neighbors.
I like to make flower paintings kind of like these ones. But I'm going to start making hibiscuses here. And so I just made a rough sketch and I'm putting the sketch down on some nice yellow paint.
At 24, she's the youngest artist at the studio door.
I think it's just really cool because it's like a level up for me. Like, I finally have a place just to be creative, and there's all these other cool artists, and like we're all just like, yeah, like creative juices all in here. So I'm like really like grateful to be here.
Studio Door offers Hillcrest a diverse palette, not only in terms of the age, gender, and race of its artists, but also in terms of media and techniques. In addition to painting, you can find clay sculpture, bronze casting, fused glass, photography, and mixed media in styles ranging from delightfully bizarre three-dimensional work to vibrantly painted canvases.
Art is very personal, and when you buy something, it's because something touches you. It speaks to you in a certain way, and so we hope that we're giving the artists and the people who want their art that connection.
Sales at the studio door have been 4 times higher in its first month than at any time while in North Park. The reason's not clear. The new location in Hillcrest definitely provides better foot traffic. But maybe fate has finally placed the studio door at the perfect intersection of art and commerce.
I think the arts often get dismissed as something that's frivolous. And the arts is a million-dollar economic driver in San Diego. So I think that creative spaces also allow community to have a voice in their identity. And the arts are so important in creating community identity. And so I don't think that the arts should be so easily dismissed because of all of the things that they're bringing to the community.
The studio door's location has changed, but not its mission. It still strives to make art accessible and affordable to the public, while at the same time helping artists navigate the marketplace and try to earn a living. Beth Accomando, KPBS News.